Hello, and welcome to this presentation, Getting Started with the HM8123 Programmable Counter. In this presentation, we'll provide a short introduction to using the HM8123 to perform basic frequency-related measurements. This presentation assumes a basic understanding of frequency counters and their applications. If you're not familiar with frequency counters, or if you'd like a brief review, you might want to watch the presentation Understanding Frequency Counters before beginning this presentation. The Rohde & Schwarz HM8123 is a benchtop programmable frequency counter that's available in two models. The standard HM8123 has a temperature-controlled oscillator, and the HM8123X has an oven-controlled oscillator for greater stability. Both models have three front panel inputs, two B and C connectors that can measure signals from DC to 200 MHz, and a single SMA input that covers the range of 100 MHz to 3 GHz. The HM8123 can provide up to 10 digits of resolution when the gate time is set to 10 seconds or longer. It supports a wide range of measurement types and functions, and also has external connectors for an external reference, triggering, gating, and arming. In the remainder of this presentation, we'll explain how to use the HM8123 to make a variety of frequency-related measurements. Let's start by looking at the most important front panel buttons and connectors. The three input connectors are on the bottom right, and measurement results are displayed on the top left, just above the measurement function keys. The keys for both level and gate settings, as well as for input controls such as attenuation, filtering, and coupling, are found above the input connectors. The measurement controls can be used to pause or reset measurements, and they're also used with the front panel trigger in connector. Next, we'll look at the various measurement functions and measurement controls, and then discuss level and gate settings. After that, we'll cover controls for filtering and conditioning the input signals, as well as triggering parameters. And we'll end by going over the functions of the rear panel connectors. The most fundamental counter measurement is frequency, and this can be measured on each of the three front input panel connectors of the HM8123. Note that the two B and C connectors for input A and B, and the SMA connector for input C, have different frequency ranges and maximum voltages, and the input impedance of C is fixed at 50 ohms. The measured frequency at each connector can be displayed by pressing the corresponding frequency key. For example, frequency A to see the frequency on channel A. Note that only one input frequency can be displayed at a time. The period and total functions are only available on input A. Period can be measured by pressing the period A button. This is the time between events or transitions. The total A key begins a count of all events seen. This can be reset by pressing total again, using the reset button, or by means of a signal at the reset B and C connector on the rear panel. The width button displays the width or on time of a square wave. Duty A measures the duty cycle, which is defined as the width over the period, expressed as a percentage. Like period and total, these functions are only available on input A. Next, we'll look at the frequency ratio between inputs A and B, which is enabled using the AB key. Note that the best accuracy is obtained if the higher frequency is applied to channel A. The phase AB button measures the phase difference in degrees between the A and B inputs. Unlike frequency ratio, this phase difference measurement is only possible on square wave signals. Another type of two-channel measurement is time intervals. The TIAB key is used to measure the time interval between a signal on channel A, defined as the start pulse, and a signal on channel B, or the stop pulse. This is measured in units of seconds. The average interval can be calculated and displayed by pressing the measurement key TIAVERAGEAB. The offset, hold, and reset keys control how measurement results are displayed or updated. Pressing the offset key causes the currently measured result to be taken as a reference, and all subsequent measurements will be subtracted from this result. In this case, both the difference as well as the reference values are displayed. the hold key freezes or pauses the update of displayed values. And the reset key clears and restarts the total count measurements that we looked at earlier. The level A and level B keys are used to set the channel A and channel B trigger levels. The measured voltage transition must exceed this level to be counted. Gate time can be set to the range of 1 millisecond to 65.5 seconds. Input signal transitions are counted and averaged over this time period. Increasing the gate time will improve measurement accuracy, but will also increase the time needed to obtain a measurement result. Note that the gate time must be greater than one period of the signal. When the gate is open, the gate LED beneath the power button will be illuminated, so it's normal to see this light flashing during operation. Independent input controls are provided for both channel A and channel B. When illuminated, the slope key indicates that triggering is being done on the falling edge of the input signal. When the LED is off, then triggering is being done on the rising edge, which is also the default. The DC key blocks DC signals when off, but it should be enabled when measuring signals with a frequency of less than approximately 10 Hz. The LP50 kHz key activates a 50 kHz low-pass filter, which can be used to remove high-frequency noise on the input signal. The 50 ohm key changes the input impedance from 1 mega ohm to 50 ohms. And finally, the two 110 keys each attenuate the input signal by a factor of 10. If they are both enabled, the total attenuation factor is 100. Keep in mind that proper signal attenuation is important for accurate measurement results. Next, let's look at triggering. Channels A and B can use either manual or automatic triggering. The channel C trigger level is not user configurable. To enable automatic triggering, press the Auto Trigger button. Note that this mode requires AC coupling, that is, the DC LED must be off. In automatic mode, the signal amplitude is measured and the trigger level is then set to 50% of this value. To manually set the trigger value, use the level keys mentioned previously. Ideally, the trigger level should be set to about 50% of the signal amplitude. If the level is set correctly, the trigger LED will blink. If the trigger LED is on continuously, this means the trigger level has been set too low. And if it's off continuously, then the trigger level has been set too high. The gated function is enabled by pressing the gated hard key. Gated measurements use the trig arm BNC connector on the front panel. In gated mode, a rising level at this input starts the measurement gate the next time the trigger condition is met. And a falling edge on this input stops the gate. The gate time is therefore determined by these external signals, and this external signal has a higher priority than any other configured gate settings. The armed function is enabled by pressing the armed key, and this function helps prevent noise from triggering a measurement. Like gated, it uses the external trig arm input on the front panel. When this mode is enabled, a measurement is only started when either the trigger key is pressed or if there's a rising signal at the trig arm input. This arming signal or trigger button press then starts the measurement, which ends automatically at the end of the user-configured gate time. The last topic is rear panel connectors. The HM8123 comes standard with USB and RS-232 for remote control, and an optional GPIB interface is available. The HM8123 can accept a 10 MHz external reference input, and an external reset connector can be used to reset measurements in the same way as the reset button on the front panel. The gate connector outputs a voltage over the gate time, that is, between the start and stop of the measurement gate. And trigger signal outputs are provided for both channel A and channel B. Let's end with a brief summary. The Rohde & Schwarz HM8123 benchtop programmable counter can make a wide range of measurements on its three separate input connectors. These include frequency, period, duty cycle, total, phase and time differences, etc. The 8123 also supports advanced filtering and conditioning of the input signal, as well as a variety of gating and triggering options. In addition, numerous external connectors can be used as inputs and outputs for triggering, gating, etc. And finally, the HM8123 can also be remotely controlled or automated over RS-232, USB, and GPIB. This concludes our presentation, getting started with the HM8123 programmable counter. If you'd like to learn more about frequency measurements or test and measurement instruments from Rohde and Schwarz, please see the links in the video description. Thanks for watching.